Once again, good afternoon, brothers and sisters. I'm happy to see you even in the Facebook, in online. At least you are still alive. So can you say to your left and to your right, I am happy you are here. Sorry, wala palang kasama sa bahay. Just say, I'm happy you are still alive. I'm still alive, thanks be to God. So let's celebrate today, the first Saturday, as we are having our general community quarantine. Life goes on. What have you done in the past 3 months? What did you do when you are locked down in your homes? Well, many of you, they have your own stories to tell. But since I'm getting bored already for the past 3 months, I started to watch Korean dramas. I know you like K-dramas. There was one series that I like. The title is Missing. It means incomplete. And the story revolves around these four characters who are interns in the trading company. So after the time that they were interns, they made presentations, and out of the 12, only 4 were accepted. The first one was brilliant. He has a brilliant background and intelligent. But yet, in his new team, he could not fly. He has no support from his bosses. The second was smart. But the same with the first, he could not launch, he could not fly. He has no support from his bosses. He was even called arrogant. The third was a girl, brilliant, hardworking. But the team of men would not allow her to shine because of prejudice against women. And she got no support from them. The fourth one, she's not college graduate, not even a high school graduate. And he was being looked down. He was very quiet and assuming, would not complain. He would do all the errands thrown to him. But he was hardworking, passionate, and gives everything of himself for his job. His boss saw his potential, trusted him, allowed him to shine, develop, and fly. Brothers and sisters, it's a very beautiful movie. It's about comparison and contrast. The gospel today is also about comparison and contrasts. But it's not about 4 kinds of people. Here, we only have 2 kinds of people. Jesus confronts the temple authorities, which was represented by the scribes, the experts of the laws. He exposed their abuses and their pride and hypocrisy. They only want honor. They sought honor. They want to be respected. People must look up to them. He reveals their erroneous theology and bankrupt ethics or morality, which was reflected in their cravings for honor, be it in the synagogue or in the marketplaces. They're arrogant and proud kind of people. The contrast was a widow. That's the second part of the gospel reading today. We hear about the widow's mite. Jesus here publicly expressed his admiration for the poor widow, and that this poor widow gave everything that she had What is the simple coins, 3 coins, few cents, compared to the surplus the other people would put in the treasury? The woman had nothing. In fact, it was everything that she gave to the treasury. And that's why Jesus called his disciples' attention and showed him this woman who gave everything to God is the one that pleases God the most. It's not about the quantity. It's not about having to give so much, thousands, millions of pesos for charity or whatever, or the church. It's why you give it. It's from the heart, how you give it, the love, and you give everything. We can even hear the saying that when you love, you give everything, even if it hurts. That is true love. The widow in the gospel reading today gives everything, and the Lord sees the motive and intention behind the action of the woman. So what could be the lesson for us? The lesson is, while we judge people by what they possess, sometimes we look at people with what they have, accomplishments, backgrounds, not only educational backgrounds, but even their accumulated wealth. And we assess them and say, these are good people. No, for Jesus, He looks at the heart. He looks at our motives and intentions. He looks at what is behind our action. Why do we do things the way we do them? Why? Why do you love? Why do you give help to the poor? Why do you care? That's more important for the Lord. He evaluates us on the basis of the sacrifice we make for others. Sometimes they are just hidden. No people can see what we are doing. Like a mother who loves her children, who wakes up early in the morning, sleeps late at night, who would take care of the children. The father who would be working so hard, not showing the stress, tiredness at work, just to provide food on the table. There are so many sacrifices that are hidden to people's eyes. But then God sees everything, just like He saw the widow's mite. Very insignificant, but to the Lord, it means a lot, because He could see how much love the woman puts in there. How about you when you help, when you care? What is your intention? What is your motive? Is it for show off? Is it for others to applaud you? Or is it because you truly love, you truly care? Today, as we celebrate this first Saturday, we have the message. It's very clear. We have the lesson. Do not judge by the appearance or what people possess. Look into the heart of the person, just like Jesus did.